Hello all, my name is Sujin George and welcome to this lecture series of Serving. Today we'll be discussing about setting out simple curve by Rankine's method of tangential or deflection angles. Now this method is actually an angular method of setting out simple curve. We have seen in the previous videos that simple curves could be set out with the help of linear method and angular method. The linear method was solved by offsets from chord produce method. The angular method will be solved by Rankine's method of tangential or deflection angles. Now, before deriving the formula for this, we should know what a deflection angle is. A deflection angle to any point on the curve is the angle at PC, that is point of curve, between the back tangent and the chord from PC to that point. Now, for example, according to this statement, suppose this is the curve. It is saying a deflection angle to any point on the curve. This is the curve, any point on the curve. Suppose this is one point. Let us call this as point A. Is the angle at PC? PC is what? This is PC, that is point of curve. This we all know. Between the back tangent, this is the back tangent. Between this angle, this deflection angle is between the back tangent and the chord from PC to that point. Means chord from PC to that point, means to the point A, means it is the angle between the back tangent and from the angle between the back tangent and the chord from PC to that point, means this angle will be called as the deflection angle. Okay, suppose there is another angle, for example, this is another point B. So the chord, if we connect this point from PC to point B, that is this chord, so the angle between back tangent and this chord will be another deflection angle. Let this be deflection angle 1, so this will be deflection angle 2. Another point, if this is another point and this chord is made, so deflection angle will be this angle, delta 3, between the back tangent and this chord from PC to that point. Okay, so this thing you have to keep in mind. And the principle of Rankine's method says that the deflection angle, or you can also call it as the tangential angle, deflection or tangential angle to any point on a circular curve is measured by 1/2 the angle subtended by the arc from PC to that point. This means that suppose this is the tangents and this is the curve. We already saw the deflection angle. Suppose this is the angle delta. Okay, and the angle subtended at its center, it will be equal to twice of delta. Okay, that is what it is trying to say. Deflection angle to any point on a circular curve is measured by 1/2 the angle subtended by the arc from PC to that point. Means this angle will be equal to half of this angle. This angle will be equal to half of this angle. That is what it is trying to say. Means if this is 2 delta, so half of 2 delta will be equal to delta itself. Okay. So the assumption made in this is that length of the arc is approximately equal to its chord. It means that length of arc, suppose this is the arc and this is the chord. This is the arc and this is the chord. You can call this as the arc or this can be called as the curve itself. Okay, so length of arc is approximately equal to the length of chord itself. Okay, so if this is the arc and this is the chord, so both will be same. That we have to assume in this. Okay, So let us derive the expression for the deflection angles. So for that we need to make a diagram. Let us make a curve. This curve has this center O and it has a radius equal to R. Okay, this is the radius R and this is the center O of the curve. Now let us draw a tangent to this radius. Now we know that tangent will always be perpendicular to the radius. Okay, so this tangent, it will always be perpendicular to the radius. Okay, so let us call this as tangent PQ. And this will be the point of curve. Let us call this as point T1. This T1 is actually the point of curve PC, because from here the alignment of the tangent, it changes from tangent to a curve. Okay, this is the point where the curve actually begins, hence it is known as the point of curve. Let us mark three points on the curve. Suppose this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. Let us join these points with the center of the curve. Okay, so obviously this will also be equal to the radius. Okay, this length OA and this length OB will also be equal to the radius of the curve. Now let us join this points T1A, AB and BC. So these are actually the chords T1A, AB and BC. Let us call them as C1, C2 and C3. Now again, if we consider this point A, let us mark tangents to this point A. The tangent will be perpendicular to the radius. This is the tangent to A. Similarly, let us mark a tangent to this point B. Again, the tangent will be perpendicular to the radius. Okay, now here we got that this is actually the back tangent. This tangent PQ is actually the back tangent. Here this chords C1, C2 and C3, they are length of chords T1A, AB and BC. Okay, this T1A is equal to C1, AB is equal to C2 and BC is equal to C3. Now let us say that this tangent line PQ is tangent at this point T1. So let us call this as the tangential angle delta 1. Now this line is tangent at this point A. So let us call this as tangential angle delta 2. This line is tangent at this point B. So let us call this as tangential angle delta 3. Hence here delta del 1, del 2 and del 3. They are actually the tangential angles. These are the tangential angles, or you can also call them as the angles which each of the successive chords, that is T1A, AB and BC, makes with the respective tangents to the curve at T1A and B. Okay, so this del 1 is this angle between the back tangent and this chord C1. This del 2 is the angle between the tangent and this chord C2. This del 3 is the angle between the tangent and this chord BC. Okay, so hence it is known as the tangential angles. Now let us join this T1 with B. Let us join T1 and B. So this is T1B. Let us also join T1C. So this is T1C. Now here, from the deflection angle, it is said that a deflection angle to any point on the curve is the angle at PC. Angle at PC, this is the point PC, between the back tangent, between the back tangent and the chord from PC to that point. Suppose we need to find the deflection angle at point A. So deflection angle at point A will be equal to this angle. Okay, see, this is the angle between the back tangent from and the chord from PC to that point. So this angle is equal to the deflection angle. So let and this angle is also equal to the tangential angle del 1. So let us call this as deflection angle delta 1 is also equal to this tangential angle del 1. Again, if we want to find deflection angle to this point B, what will be the deflection angle to this point B? Now, deflection angle to any point, suppose this is point B. So point B on the curve, this is point B on the curve, is the angle at PC between the back tangent and the chord from PC to that point B. Means this angle will be delta 2, that is the deflection angle. Similarly, if we need to find the deflection angle to point C, then that angle will be the angle between the back tangent to the and the chord from PC to that point C. So this angle is delta 3. So delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, they are the deflection angle. They are the deflection angles to the points A, B, C respectively. Okay, see, deflection angle to point A is this delta 1. Deflection angle to this point B is this delta 2. And deflection angle to this point C is this total delta 3. Okay, that is the concept of deflection angle. Now, if we know from this principle, from the principle of Rankine's method, we get that the deflection angle to any point on a circular curve is equal to one half the angle subtended by the arc from PC to that point. Now, what does this indicate? This means that this angle QT1A, means this angle QT1A, will be equal to half of this angle T1OA. Half of T1OA. Okay, or this can also be written as angle T1OA is equal to twice of angle QT1A, isn't it? So angle QT1A is equal to what? this angle is equal to del 1, this is equal to 2 del 1. Okay, so what we got from here, that this angle T1OA is equal to twice of del 1. Fine. Now similarly, if we go by the similar principle, if this is the tangential angle del 2, then the angle subtended at the center will be equal to what? It will be 2 del 2. Similarly, if this is the tangential angle del 3, so the angle subtended at the center will be equal to 2 del 3. Okay, this is the principle of Rankine's method. Now, if we need to find the length of the curve, now from the elements of the simple curve, we know that the length of curve formula is given by, see, in this case, if we need to find the length of this curve. So, we know that this is the central angle 2 delta 1, 2 del 1. Okay, suppose if we consider it like this. See, we are only considering this arc. That is, this is T1, this is A, and this is O. This is T1AO. This angle is 2 del 1. Now, suppose if this is the tangent, and here the forward tangent is also made over here. So, if this is 2 del 1, if this angle is 2 del 1, obviously this external deflection angle will also be equal to 2 del 1, isn't it? This external deflection angle will also be equal to 2 del 1 if the central angle is 2 del 1. This we have already discussed in the properties of the circle when we calculated the, when we derived the terms and notations for the circular curve. Then if this is 2 del 1, this will also be equal to 2 del 1, provided these two are the tangents. So, if this is 2 del 1, so what will be the length of arc? See, length of the curve, that will be equal to pi r into the deflection angle, that is the external deflection angle. Now, external deflection angle is 2 del 1 into 2 del 1 upon 180 degree. Okay. This is actually the external deflection angle. Okay, we actually derived it as pi r delta upon 180 degree because we considered this angle as delta. Okay, this external deflection angle as delta we had considered. Hence, we wrote this angle as pi r delta upon 180. But here delta is equal to 2 del 1. Okay, this delta is equal to 2 del 1. So, this length of curve, what we are assuming? We are assuming that length of arc, or you can call it as the length of curve also, length of curve is approximately equal to its chord. So it means that this curve, this is the chord, okay, this is the chord C1, okay, T1A is equal to C1, we have already mentioned over here that this T1A is equal to this C1. So this length of curve is equal to length of chord itself. So we can write this as C1, length of curve is equal to length of chord equal to C1 is equal to pi r into del 1 upon 90 degree, 2 upon 180 will be equal to 90 degree. So del 1 is equal to what? Del 1 is equal to 90 degree C1 upon pi r, and this value is in degrees. You will get the unit of del 1 in degrees. If you need to convert this degree to minutes, we know that 1 degree is 60 minutes. So del 1 will be equal to 90 into 60 into C1 upon pi r. This will be in minutes because 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So, after calculating this value, it comes out to 1718.9 C1 upon R. This value, it comes out to 1718.9 C1 upon R, and this will be in minutes. Means the unit of del 1, it will be in minutes. Fine. Now, similarly, this, if del 1 is this, so del 2 will be equal to 1718.9 C2 upon R, again in minutes. Del 3 will be equal to 1718.9 C3 upon R in minutes. So what will be the general equation or general expression for calculating this value of this tangential angle? This is actually the tangential angle del. So del will be equal to 1718.9 C by R, okay, in minutes. So this is the angle for calculating, or this is the formula for calculating the tangential angle. Now, if we consider this figure, now for this first point A, this deflection angle is equal to the tangential angle itself. See, del 1 is equal to delta 1 itself. So we can write over here, for the first point A, this tangential angle is equal to deflection angle itself. Now, if we go to the second point, that is this point, second point B, what will be the deflection angle to this point B? The deflection angle to this point B is equal to this delta 2, isn't it? So, for the second point B, deflection angle is equal to delta 2. See, this, for this point B, this deflection angle is equal to this total whole delta 2. Now here, since this del 2 is the tangential angle to the chord AB, this del 2 is actually tangential angle to the chord AB, okay, so this angle AOB will be equal to 2 del 2, isn't it? From the principle of Rankine's method, angle AOB will be equal to twice of del 2, isn't it? So we can write over here, since del 2 is equal to tangential angle to chord AB. See, this del 2 is equal to the tangential angle to this chord AB. Hence, this tangential angle to any point on a circular curve is measured by 1/2 the angle subtended by the arc from PC to that point. So hence, this angle AOB will be equal to, twice of del 2. Therefore, we can say that this angle AT1B, it will also be equal to del 2. Okay, this angle AT1B will also be equal to del 2. Angle AT1B is also equal to del 2, because it is equal to half the angle subtended by AB at the center. See, it is equal to half of the angle subtended by this chord AB at the center. So this angle AT1B will also be equal to del 2. So from here we can say that this total deflection angle delta 2 will be equal to what? This angle del 1 plus del 2. See, this total deflection angle is del 1 plus del 2. Therefore, total delta 2 will be equal to del 1 plus del 2. But here, this del 1 is equal to delta 1 itself. Del 1 is equal to delta 1 plus del 2. Okay. Now, similarly, if this is delta 2, if this is the tangential angle del 3, okay, this is the tangential angle del 3 to the chord BC. If this is the tangential angle del 3, so obviously this angle will also be equal to del 3, because this is half the angle subtended by this chord BC at the center. Okay, this is equal to half the angle subtended by chord BC at the center. So this angle will be del 3. So this total delta 3, see, this total delta 3 will be equal to what? It will be equal to del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3. This total is equal to delta 3, that is del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3, isn't it? So delta 3 will be equal to del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3. But this angle, this total angle del 1 plus del 2, this will be equal to, this is equal to delta 2 only. See, this del 1 plus del 2 is equal to delta 2 itself. So this can be written as delta 2 plus del 3. Okay. Similarly, if there is another deflection angle delta 4, so that will be equal to del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3 plus del 4. And in this case, del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3, it is equal to delta 3. So this will be delta 3 plus del 4. So the general equation to calculate the value of, if you need to calculate nth value of this deflection angle delta. Okay, so the nth value for n value, it will be delta n is equal to del 1 plus del 2 plus, it will go till del n, or it can be written as delta n minus 1 plus del n, delta n minus 1 plus del n. So here this deflection angle for any chord, okay, this is the deflection angle for any chord, it will be equal to this. What will be this? This will be deflection angle for the previous chord plus, this is the tangential angle for that chord. Okay, so suppose this delta n is the deflection angle for any chord, that will be equal to this deflection angle for the previous chord. Delta n minus 1 is the deflection angle for previous chord, plus del n is the tangential angle for that same chord. See, this is n, here it is n, so this will also be n, so it is tangential angle for that same chord. Okay, so this is how this is the final equation for calculating the deflection angle for any chord. Now there is an arithmetical check. When you solve numericals on this, there is an arithmetical check for this. Whether you have done it correctly or not, there is a check, and this check is given by delta n is equal to del by 2. Delta n is equal to del by 2, where this delta n is equal to this only, that is del 1 plus del 2 plus till del n. See, delta n is this, del 1 plus del 2 till del n is equal to delta by 2. And here, where this delta is equal to the external deflection angle. Okay, this external deflection angle is this angle. See, this angle, that is the external deflection angle. Means if this is the tangent and this is the curve, and this is the external deflection angle delta. Okay, so this delta, so this delta by 2 will be equal to this delta n, that is del 1 plus del 2 plus till del n. Okay, this is the arithmetical check to check to see whether you have done the numerical correctly or not. Okay, so this was the method of setting out simple curve by Rankine's method of tangential or deflection angles. This is the angular method, and we'll be solving a numerical on this in my next video. Okay, any doubt in this derivation, you can ask in the chat box. Thank you so much.